see. You've come up to, or 90, we do 61 meters.
Yeah, it's 2 kilo.
Why?
Why? Yeah, because I had a train every day. And he probably not.
Yeah. Yeah. So from 13 you train?
No, it was 15. It was 15 I had started. It was 15, it was 1969, I did train, I started to train harder. And before was also I had a time where I did no training.
So you started to lift weights now at 15?
Hard. I did start with 12 or 13 to lift weights, but easy, very easy.
What age were you when you started doing the Olympic lift? I say you do it.
It was 15. Yeah, what it was the most how I remember was 15. Also the Olympic lifting. Yeah. Before squats, bench press, a little bit, it was more easy training. But it was not playing around. It was a little bit more.
Yes. Did that explain what kind of when you were at your peak for this season, and then after a number of days a week, the weights, and whether you've got hard 1 week, this is next week, that sort of thing, what exercises you use, shoulders 1 day, legs next day, that sort of thing. Could you explain about that? So how many days a week?
Yeah, I didn't. 2 to 3 times a week weightlifting. It's I did the most I did was 5 times weightlifting in a week, and I think for you it's possible 2 to 3 times a week weightlifting, and yeah, I did twice a week bench press, twice a week squats, twice a week. Snatch, once a week power clean. Depends on how I did feel and what was on the plan to do. If I did 5 times a week, for example, weightlifting, I did 3 times squats in this week. Yeah.
And did you have your 1 week like next week?
Yes, I did. I did. One thing was when we had a hard week. For example, 11 times training, and the next week we did 6, 7, or 8 training. So it was always up and down. After a hard week, you need time to recover. So you have to have rest.
We are alternating in weight, so maybe do 80% maximum 1 week, maybe drop that to 75 the following week, that you keep it at the same weight level.
No, I said it was changing after a hard week.
No, I thought maybe you were doing 11 sessions 1 week and then 7 sessions the following week, but maybe keeping the same weight steady.
Yeah, it was nearly the same weight. Yeah, it depends on how strong you could do it. Yeah. Always, you have always to try to do more.
Do you use the snatch? Do you use a squat or a split?
A split. I think it's for the thrower, it's good to use the split, I think. I do it, but another thrower like McWilkins, they lift very like Olympic lifter, so they don't use the split.
Wolfgang, you've explained what kind of training you do within your throwing and how you practice without the discus. What kind of work would a 15-year-old do in your country? when perhaps someone comes and says, I want to be a discus thrower, how do you start to teach them the technique, and how does it build into a full turn the way that you do it?
Yeah.
Can you explain a little on how you sort of teach these youngsters?
Right, it's visualization, it's a way of learning skills.
And a dream about it. No, and very good is for young athletes to watch video. Yeah. Not the Muppet Show. No much. Discus video. Yeah. So mentally training, I did also a lot.
Did you have a sports psychologist?
No, they have it in East Germany, but I didn't want one.
You're strong enough.
I think, I hope so. So more question? For you, everything is fine.
When you were at East Germany,
and other things.
How much further do you throw the wind and no wind?
What? I think you can throw 5 meters further.
When you threw
four,
when you threw
3 to 5 meters.
When you threw 70 meters, did you were you as strong as you were when you threw 71?
No.
You were stronger then?
Yes. But it was a very good throw.
You look thinner then, though, when you threw 71. You were, you look thinner.
Thinner, yes, I was, yeah.
So you're heavier now?
Yes.
What is your body weight now?
120. Like this 17 years old boy.